Hi, hello, I am Vishwanath Pink from Komalapati High School. Today, I am going to teach about the Pathwar of Indian Independence Continue part. Before that, I will try to remember some or few tips or points what I have taught in yesterday class. Dear students, what are the causes for the 1857 revolt? The first one is political causes, second one is economic causes, third one is administrative causes, fourth one is military causes, already discussed. But another one, fifth one, very very important causes for the 1857 revolt, that was immediate causes. What were the immediate causes for the 1857 revolt? See, Britishers introduced a Royal Enfield rifle. It was fired by the cat of pig and cow. So that was against the Hindus and Muslims religious beliefs. So in Meerut and Barrackpore, so many places start revolt. That rumor was spread all over India. Smear the cat of pig and cow. In Barrackpore mutiny, British officers ordered to Indian soldiers to use new Royal Enfield rifles. So that Royal Enfield rifle bullets were speared cat of cow and pigs. It must be trained the rifle to open the bullet. That's why the British officer ordered to use it. One of the Indian soldier, Mangal Pandey, refused to do it and shoot out the British officer. Immediately, British officers arrested him and hanged him to death. That event was spread all over India. That was the immediate causes for the 1857 revolt. Dear students, that time, the 1857 revolt became gradually growing up. But when happened that event, the 1857 revolt start more and more dangerous way all over the India. Like that, Meerut, Barrackpore, Jhansi, Satara, Jaipur, Udaipur, even in Karnataka, Mangalore, Ullam, like that, so many places, that revolt was started. But this revolt became failure. Why? Why that the Pathwar of Indian Independence became failure? That is the continuation part of this lesson. The topic is the reasons for the failure of the mutiny. What are the reasons? Why not become that 1857 revolt success? So there are so many reasons for the failure of 1857 revolt. The first one is, due to the various reasons, it did not cover every part of India. See, the first one reason for the failure of 1857 revolt, this mutiny, this war of Indian independence, or the war, not They start about whatever they think, whatever their way, but there is no plan. These 3 points are very, very important. Made the failure of 1857 revolt. And fourth one, there were many unexpected results. Their expectation, winning to get freedom. But what happened? The unexpected results, lootings, plundering, so many misactivities happened in the form of 1857 revolt. That's why the 1857 revolt became failure. Next one, the unity among the British and the disunity among the Indian soldiers resulted in its failure. That is very, very important. Unity is very, very important. But comparatively, Indian soldiers to the British, they have good unity in British soldiers. Compared to Indian soldiers, we did not have good unity among themselves. So that's why disunity among the Indian soldiers, what is the result? Result is failure. Next one point, the mutiny lack of direction and leadership. See, any institution, any organization, it becomes success by the good directions and good leadership. But in 1857 revolt, there is no good direction. Go this way, go this direction, go this way. That is a good manner, good way. No one ready to guide them. And also, very few persons good leadership qualities, but others couldn't. So how can our Indian 1857 revolt become success? Nothing. So, lack of direction and also leadership made the 1857 revolt become failure. Now, the soldiers also lack discipline. Britishers, well-disciplined persons, soldiers also, compared to the Indian soldiers and persons, they were not disciplined in manner. So, lack of discipline and organizing skills not developed in our Indian soldiers. And Indian people's skill also very important to success anything in our walk of life. So, that type of organizing skills we did not find in the 1857 Sipahi Mutiny. Next one, the Indian soldiers lack military strategies. See how the Britishers they have with guns. That was the good strategy to the against persons or enemies, isn't it? But Indian soldiers, they were gone. They went to their 1857 revolt without weapons. There is no strategy. So, next, the planning capabilities. They have some plans, but it was relevant to their capacity, capabilities, and the soldiering skills. Soldier must learn the skill of soldiering. So, Indian soldiers did not have such type of qualities among themselves. These are all main reasons for the failure of 1857 revolt. Definitely. The same. like that in our 1857 revolt the freedom fighters are revolutionaries they don't have good way good aim but the definite plan and definite aim is very essential here but that type of aim not found in the 1857 revolt that's why that's become the failure of the 1857 revolt next one many of the Indian kings extended their loyalties to the British and did not support the freedom fighters see very very fantastic very very dangerous why because Dushman Khan hai Dushman ka kaam hai agar mein hai like that Indian kings and at some native rulers did not support to the Indian army Indian soldiers mutiny people and indirectly support to the Britishers indirectly support to the Britishers so some of native rulers supported to the Britishers not to the Sipahis that's why it is a great reason for the 1857 revolt failure The plundering and other crimes committed by the Sipahis made them to lose the faith of common people. Some revolutionaries or Sipahis made some loots, some plundering, some destruction of land, asset, anything else. So they did not ready to get good faith from the people. So they lose the faith of common people. So when they lose the faith of common people, no one ready to come forward support to them. So the Sipahi mutiny become very low. So these are all the important reason for the failure of 1857 revolt. Next we shall discuss about the results of the mutiny. Already we have discussed what are the reason for the failure of 1857 revolt. Dear students, remember yourself the what are the reason for the 1857 revolt are different from what are the reason for the failure of the 1857 revolt that's why these are two ways different points but what are the results already failure okay but what are the results happened by the 1857 revolt it is also very very important it is helpful to future struggle in Indians the part one outcomes are result of 1857 revolt the governance of East India Company came into an end before that the East India Company ruled over India when the first war of Indian independence happened the governance of East India Company rule came into end the effect of 1857 revolt next the governance of British government started instead of East India Company British government directly start the rule over India that is the main important results next second one the Queen of Britain passed a declaration in 1858 second point result the Queen of Britain declared some points of declaration in 1858 queen, and also it was the Magna Carta of our India because it was very significant. That's why it became Magna Carta. But how the aspects were mentioned in the 1858 Magna Carta or Declaration of Queen. See, first one is the agreement entered by the company with the local kings were accepted. What are the agreement happened between company and Indians? These were accepted by the Indian kings. First one. Second one. Non-pursuance of regional expansion. Queen declared, "We are not ready to expand our British areas in India." It was assured by declaration of Queen. Second one. Third one. Providing a stable government for Indians. Before that, the Indian people didn't have governing capacity, governing power, but Queen declared and assured providing a stable government for Indians. So it is helpful to India because of effect of 1857 revolt. Then fourth one, equality before the law. Before that, inequality existed all over India. But now, equality before the law, that means each and everybody equal in front of the law declared by Queen. Non-interference of the government in religions. Before that, Britishers interfere all fields of Indian religious fields, but assured that the British government not entered into the any aspects of religious in Indians and issues of Indians, any issues of Indians and practicing religious tolerance. You are free to practice either Hindus, Muslims, whatever religions. Assurance assured by the declaration of Queen in 1858. So these are all the main aspects of 1857 revolt or results. Then the British remain that unless and until they come on, the love and affection of Indians ruling India would be a difficult proposition. In this way, the Britishers came to conclusion without getting any love and affection of Indians, we are not able to rule over India. That's why they came to conclusion to get love and affection of Indians by the effect of 1857 revolt. See, next, the inability to listen to the voice of Indians was considered as the main reason for the violence. They don't have the listening skill on those days. So they thought that the inability to listen made the Indian people start the voice against the British. They come to the conclusion to take peace and love and affection from the Indians. That's why they decided to involve the Indians in the process of legislation and implemented policy of association. See, what is the policy of association? Britishers have given the permission, power, association. That means pitchers have given the rights to participate the process of Indian legislation. That was the policy of association. So this picture have give us the ideas of all Indian people and Britishers also equal in front of the law. The First War of Indian Independence is like a guide. What guide? For future struggle. And this was also outlined the importance of seeking alternative channels to pursue future struggles against the British. It is a beginning step of weapon to start revolt against the British to the freedom struggle. So it was helpful to Indians to start the revolt and start the freedom struggle against the British. It was the beginning steps. So in this way, the First War of Indian Independence came into end. So 1857 revolt, some points are failure and some points are helpful to Indians for a future struggle. It was helpful to Indian people. Okay, next we will start next another one class. That lesson was end with the result. Thank you.